here I am. I'm still in this campaign. What I'm trying to do is I have the manual target, and then I have the automatic target, and I'm trying to decipher. Some of the automatic is working and the manual isn't, and then the manual is working and the automatic isn't. So it's like, and then and so some cost, much more. And I'm like, I do see there's a drop, a small drop in the price, little by little, but it's really a slow drop. It's not going fast. And so I don't know, I just feel like this is a brick wall that I'm facing, that it really puts me like, this is like a Blade Runner time already, that this is the direction that we're headed with these big online corporations. It's just that we are at the whim of their rules. They've created these rules, and there's been no government that says, no, that's the wrong way to go. They haven't been doing that. They have not been. They tried, I think, a few things, but not enough. And so, but when it comes to this cost per click thing, they really have just destroyed people of the books, destroyed us. Because when you think about it, if you're a real business, you're like 30%, you're saying, okay, I'll buy that item here, and 30%, I will allow that can go towards advertising. That's normal. The cost of your purchase of this goes towards advertising. So let's say I bought this item for $3, wholesale. Then I allow $1 of that to go toward to advertising, and then I have the one that I collect for overhead of the company to keep it afloat, and the last of the third dollar goes to profit. It's a very simple concept. But with books, they apparently don't go by that, and I believe that already is a fraud that needs to be addressed. All the books have to be given the 30%. That is a fair business deal. Fair business, 30% on your advertising cost to the actual sale, to the cost of the. Maybe people don't understand me. I don't know. It's pretty simple. The 3 to 1, but I don't know. So when what I'm really trying to say here is it just gives me this feeling already that this compendium of Blade Runner is already here, that we're already warehoused, that we're already in that. Like, it's sending people into the apocalypse tone. It's sending people into, and you're like, oh no, everything is all normal, and all normal. No, it's not. No, it's not. Because I know if this is happening to me, I know there are thousands and thousands and thousands it's happening to also, and they're not in my predicament necessarily. They could be in far worse predicament. So in those far worse predicaments, we end up with I will say it's more of a seedy side to business. And that seedy side to business is really, it's all about that, isn't it? It's all about the corporation, the big magnitude corporation online, and the fear, and the people working in the back of everything. In the dark markets, the black markets, the illegal trades, all of that starting, more and more, because they can't compete, because in the original rule set here being made in this wild west of online, the original rule set being made is not giving the fairness out. It's not giving the fairness. Here at today, it was $27 spent, $28 spent, and one book sale, again, only one book sale. And I have so many locks on the thing and everything, keywords to say no. I have over 1,000 negative keywords on each book. And still I'm being hit. Today I was hit $7 by these things called ASINs. And they're just robots that go out and they seem to list out all of the ones that are similar to yours, and they go wham, 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 and they seem to click through everybody. And I get hit $7. And it's a little ASIN code, and then it says the name of the title of the book. And then there's another ASIN code and another title of the book. That's not a normal lookup from a normal human being. That's a robot. That's a bot system. And because this mega corporation online is allowing it to happen, they're just ruining honesty and loyalty and good business tactics. So anyway, I'm like I said, so now I'm getting to the point now. I'm cutting them off now. I'm starting to just, that's it. And those ASINs are happening on the automatic one. And it's like I'm being attacked specifically, because they're very similar to my particular name of the book, very close. And so anyway, so it's like I don't know, just I understand this is the peasant world, and I'm just another peasant talking, and it doesn't matter what I say, that I'm just one of the ones yelling out there for bread at Versailles. It's never ever gonna be anything but wasted breath. The big corporations can do what they want, and I can come out here like a big ha ha, you do this because I say so. But at the end of the day, they steamroll over everybody until we're dead. That's what's happening. They just steamroll over us. They don't have a care. They don't have a care for us. Not a single human being. It is the same autocracy that's happened all throughout history. They're just the new kings in charge. And this new king is Bezos. This new king is whoever the in charge of Facebook. They're the new kings. Who's in charge of eBay? The new king's in charge. And here we are. How do you riot in this moment? How do you riot when we're being mistreated, when we're being overcharged, when we're being absolutely thieved? How do you riot? We're in our houses each. We're in our apartments each. How do you riot from there? Go ahead and limit my account. I saw that you did that. I really saw that you did that years and years ago. I saw that you immediately, as soon as I got any kind of membership. Oh no, we're turning that one up to 1,000, and then at 1,000, then you can earn maybe if you got 1,000. But we cut her off. You see, they cut me off, so I couldn't get to that 1,000. They made sure I couldn't earn a living. That's how, like, they are that, like, afraid of me, in my riot, in my brain, in my house, in my situation, because I have, like, the intelligence to even clarify what's going on. And then we have these jerks out here that are going, oh, this is the greatest thing ever. blah, blah, blah. It's not the greatest thing ever. It's a flash in the pan, and all you're doing is licking your stamp envelopes. And then after that has been saturated, what next, pal? What are you going to do? What are you going to eat? You know? That's not an answer. To make these little stupid notebook rush businesses to 1,000. I saw a guy, I still can't believe it. And he's like, and I'm making another 10 tonight. You know, I'm not kidding. He's making 10 notebooks a day, you know, on purpose. I made one over the weekend and I'm still like panicking over the rose where I put it. And I'm like, no, I don't think that was the right place. You know, I'm pushing and rushing my own self, and that's wrong. I'm not supposed to be in that dequalifying place. I'm supposed to be in the quality place. Anyway, yeah, just remember, this is, you know, I live here now online because this is, I'm not trying to be a futurist, but this is really our reality today. You can go out there to those retail stores or those shopping malls that are now ghost towns, but right now, this is where the action is. This is where the actual sales of the world are happening. And they're happening without like, rule sets. They're allowing just robbery to happen to each little book person. Just absolute robbery to any of these click-through people. I mean, really, if the company had any balls on loyalty, balls on ethics, they would say, if I see an ASIN like that in any of your click-throughs, they're thrown out. That is an honest business. That is somebody you trust. That those days are gone. We are looking at Blade Runner. That is it. Blink, blink. Don't you get it? It's just blinking. The ads are blinking by. Anyway, underground. That's the only way we're going to make money, is underground. That's it. You want a sure thing?